This episode is brought to you by Curiosity Stream.
All right, I need you to do a little experiment. So in your head, I want you to yell the sentence, "I like crickets," just in your head. Please don't say it out loud. And now we're gonna do the same thing, but this time, instead of yelling, I want you to whisper, "I like crickets," again, in your head. Now, consider this question. Was the actual volume of your inner voice different when you yelled versus when you whispered? It certainly might seem like it, but you can't change the volume of the voice in your head, just the tone and pitch. That's because you aren't actually hearing that voice at all. Your inner voice can feel like you're hearing yourself think, but it lives in a completely different part of your brain. And it gets weirder. So when you're just going about your day, thinking about things, do you think in words and complete sentences? I do, but a lot of people don't. Unless they're reading or writing, a lot of people report thinking in pictures, actions, or images, rather than words and sentences. And according to some scientists, there are three major types of thinkers. There are verbal thinkers, like me, who think in words or whole sentences. Pattern thinkers think in patterns and connections, which may feel like thinking in actions and emotions. Then there are visual thinkers who think in pictures and images. Most people probably do a little bit of all three, but it means that not everyone has an inner monologue, which blew my mind a little bit. That term probably came from a visual thinker. Anyway, no matter how you think, a vast majority of people report thinking in whole sentences when reading or writing. One study looked at how similar reading dialogue is to hearing it. They had participants in an fMRI scanner read different sentences in their heads. Some sentences were things like, "The man said, I like crickets," which includes dialogue. But other sentences were formatted like, "The man said that he likes crickets," which means the same thing but does not include dialogue. The study found that when sentences contain dialogue, parts of the auditory cortex are activated. You're actually hearing what the characters have to say. Even when you're just replaying or imagining a conversation in your head, some parts of the auditory cortex activate. This is different from being a verbal thinker. An inner monologue does not activate the auditory cortex, but an inner dialogue does. And it turns out what your inner reading voice sounds like is not universal. Some people read in their heads all in one voice, their own. I must admit I fall in that category. But other people read in a different voice, with an identifiable gender, pitch, or tone that is different from their own voice. This other voice might be consistent when reading, or it might change based on what you're reading. Some people even read in multiple voices, and others don't hear a voice at all. So without being able to see or hear what's going on in someone else's mind, we tend to assume that our experiences are universal. And because of this, a lot of the research wasn't done until recently. We're just starting to learn more about how the variation in our minds work and how we all experience the world a little bit differently. And that's something to think very loudly about. To think very loudly about. Okay, that's the end. You should know by now that I love watching documentaries, and at the moment I'm watching The Origami Code on Curiosity Stream. It is very satisfying if you enjoy seeing very large objects like spacecraft folded up into very tiny spaces. I want to thank Curiosity Stream for sponsoring this episode of BrainCraft. It's a subscription streaming service that has a whole range of nonfiction titles, including extensive originals. You can get unlimited access for 2 months if you sign up at curiositystream.com/BrainCraft and use the code BrainCraft during the sign up process. Thank you. One more thing, I just wanted to thank Adam, who left a comment on the BrainCraft Facebook page about inner voices. It was an interesting question and it had an interesting answer, and now here we all are having learned something new about ourselves. So thank you, Adam. You were very helpful. This is really the end now.